Now that we got the fender mounted, time to make a sissy bar. Okay, so first, I'm gonna map it all out on my table, tack down some bend points, figure out how tall, you know, just getting a bunch of numbers ready. First, I start off with figuring out how wide the base is, just right where it mounts on either of your axle plates. Mine in this case is 9 3/4 to each outside to outside. So I'm gonna find the center mark on the table, center mark, center line, measure out each way, and then just kind of start going from there. So we'll get started. And yes, soapstone is a lot easier to see, but I hate sharpening them. So if that's my bottom, also too, just want to figure out how tall you want to go. We're gonna make a short one for this one. Yeah, let's do 26. I got all these random cutoff drop pieces for whatever diameter you want, you know. You can chop the top and go straight across, you can round it, I mean, whatever you want. Give it kind of a wide bend. So we're gonna come up, kind of suck in tight over the brake rotor, get closer to the rim and tire. Now I'm gonna figure out where I wanna go from there to the fender. I know I wanna keep it pretty skinny up top. So now I just figure that out. Try to go 11 1/2 and see what that does. See what it looks like. So here's the first one. Didn't like how it turned out. So after filming yesterday, whipped up this new one, just changed the legs, widened it a little more, rounded these bottoms out, changed a couple bends here and there, but I like this one a lot better, so we're gonna roll with this one. I always put these countersinks in the bottom, like it just looks more professional. My little template, I'm just gonna good old arts and crafts time.